this evening is a regular on Triple J. You may have seen him in some of his solo shows as part of the Adelaide, Melbourne and New Zealand comedy festivals. He joins us for the first time tonight. Please welcome Justin Hamilton.
Now, I have to admit, I'm a bit of a party guy, and I used to love going to parties on a Sunday night. Now, I think we've all done this. You know when you go to a party on a Sunday night and you think, right, if I get to bed at 12, get up at 8, 8 hours sleep, I'll be right for work. Then it gets to 2 and you think, right, if I get to bed at 3, get up at 8, 5 hours sleep, I'll be right for work. Then it gets to 4 and you think, right, if I get to bed at 5, go to sleep in the clothes I'm already wearing, get up at 8:30, don't get changed, don't have a shower, don't eat breakfast, I'll be right for work. Then it gets to 7 and you're thinking, quite clearly, I'm not going to work. Can someone remind me to ring my boss? At 10 to 9, you're so drunk, you're ringing your flatmate going, dude, can you ring my boss and tell him I can't make it to work? And your flatmate's there going, dude, you've been unemployed for 2 years. Good thing I planned ahead. But I used to like partying even as a kid, and the best thing about being a kid, sugar. Because sugar messed you up, didn't it? I used to love going to those parties where the parents would forget and they'd put out cake, they'd put out lollies, and they'd put out cordial. And the kids would consume it, and 45 minutes later, you see Dad standing in the middle of the lounge room holding a big stick, looking like Obi-Wan Kenobi beating Jarvis, just going, get the hell away from me! And there's Grandpa in a corner looking like Yoda going, fruit tingles, I tell you, give them, you must not. Eventually, the kids take over the lounge room. It takes you 45 minutes to kick open the door. When you get in there, there's a kid in a corner doing lines of whiz fizz. There's a kid in the middle of the room with a killer python wrapped around his arm shooting up sherbet. There's a kid over here going, oh yeah, I just popped 7 Mentos and I don't need an afternoon sleep. Right through to 7:30 p.m. For some reason he dances like Paul McDermott, I don't know why. There were bad things to being a kid, though. Bullies were bad. We had a bully at my school who was scary for 2 reasons. One is they had facial hair. No one in grade 5 should have facial hair, should they? Second scary thing about our bully was our bully's name was Deborah. Did you have the piss pants at your school? Do you remember the piss pants where if you pissed yourself, the school would provide you with pants to wear? Now, if you piss yourself, what's the last thing you want anyone to know? That you piss yourself. So what would the school do? They provide you with bright lavender pants or orange corduroy. You might as well walk around with a megaphone saying, g'day folks, just in case you haven't noticed, I've pissed myself. Could someone please tell Deborah so she beats the snot out of me? I've got to be honest, I don't deal with aggression that well. The last time I saw Deborah, she scared me so much. I have to point out, I used to be a 6'4" black man who performed in a Marvin Gaye tribute band entitled Marvin G'day, the Marvin Gaye Down Under Experience. But I've seen the best example of aggression ever. I used to live with a 7-foot basketballer called Bert Whaler, the epitome of the gentle giant. But he one day took... by the way, that's not his real name, but if I say Brett Wheeler and he finds me, he'll kill me. But... But he took aggression to a level I've never seen before. We were going out to shoot some hoops, so he decided to pump up the basketball. But he pulled the pump out and the metal nib bit got caught in the ball. So he tried to remove it with his teeth. And as he's pulled it out, I've heard and I've looked as a bit of tooth has dropped out of his mouth. In anger, he's thrown the pump down on the ground, smashing his phone and the pump. He's run down into the bathroom, looked in the mirror, seen this jagged bit of his tooth missing, gone, ah, thrown the basketball. The basketball has flown out of the bathroom, through the lounge room, landing in the sink in the kitchen where the lazy bugger never did his dishes, smashing his crockery, and a jagged bit of the crockery has blown up his basketball. So in 30 seconds, I watched him break his tooth, his pump, his phone, his crockery, and his basketball. And you know what I did? Absolutely nothing, because I knew if I laughed, I was going to be the next little bugger broker. Don't mess with the man who destroys Tokyo. I've been Justin Hamilton. Thank you very much.
Good job, buddy.
Turn it up.